what are pentaquarks? Quarks and leptons are the fundamental particles that make up matter, and we think they're fundamental simply because we haven't found anything smaller inside them, no other constituents. Quarks make up the protons and neutrons that form atomic nuclei, which are orbited in turn by electrons, which are a type of lepton. Now, you can find leptons singly in the universe, but quarks always come linked up by one of the fundamental forces, the strong force, in particles that we call hadrons. Usually, this is a combination of a quark and an antiquark in a particle we call a meson, or else a combination of one quark with two other quarks to make a baryon. And protons and neutrons are examples of baryons. Now, the reason why quarks quite literally stick together in this way is because they have a property called colour charge. And colour charge is associated to the strong force in exactly the same way that an electric charge is associated to the electric force. It acts as a source for the force to act on. In the case of the colour charge, though, there's actually three types, and we label these red, green, and blue. Now, particles inside hadrons occupy colourless objects, which means to say that the quarks inside a meson or a baryon, their colour charges cancel each other out. So overall, the object is neutral and it doesn't experience the strong force. Now, there's no reason why you should only get two or three quarks to form a hadron. In principle, you could get any number at all, as long as they all link up in a combination whose colour charges cancel each other out. And scientists have been looking for evidence of particles containing more quarks for years and years and years. In 2003, we saw the first hints of a tetraquark, a particle containing four quarks, and the discovery was confirmed in 2008. In 2015, the LHCb experiment discovered pentaquarks, a particle containing five quarks. Since then, we've analysed nine times as much data on LHCb, we've scrutinised our pentaquark signals further, and we've learnt much more about them. It turns out that LHCb is actually a really good environment for studying pentaquarks, and that's because the Large Hadron Collider collides its particle beams together 40 million times a second inside the experiment. And in these collisions, quarks and antiquarks are created that quickly form all types of hadrons, including the super-rare, super-elusive pentaquarks, giving us a chance on LHCb to study them. The only catch is that a pentaquark is not stable. It decays quickly, so we can't see it directly with our experiment. So instead, we have to look for pentaquarks by finding the particles that they decay to. So far on LHCb, we've been looking for pentaquarks that decay to a J-psi meson and a proton, because these are particles that we can identify really well on LHCb. And that allows us to isolate, select, and analyze these events from the LHC collisions in order to be able to search for pentaquarks. Our data consists of signal and background, but you can distinguish it by looking at the combined mass of the J-psi meson and the proton. If the mass accumulates at a particular characteristic value, then you have signal. If you have a background combination, then the mass is pretty random. When we looked at our data, we saw three peaks. Each one of these peaks corresponds to a new and distinct pentaquark signal. Now, this is really exciting because we don't know very much about pentaquarks, and that in turn means we don't know that much about the behavior of the strong force that forms them. So, for example, we don't even know if a pentaquark is made of a meson and a baryon that sit loosely together, or if it's made of a really tightly held bundle of five quarks. But what we do know is that we have the experimental apparatus to study this further. Our observation has shown us that we have the ability to investigate pentaquarks. So although we don't know the answer yet, by the time we've analysed more data, we should be able to say something definitive about how a pentaquark is formed and what sticks it together. Longer term, you might be wondering why pentaquarks are so interesting or what relevance this has for your life. So in answer to that, I'd just like to point out the last time we really investigated a charge, the electric charge, which led to the discovery of electricity, which was investigated in great detail by Michael Faraday here in the Royal Institution, then this led to applications that have really revolutionised our lives in every aspect. So who knows what is going to come out of our investigations of this colour charge and the strong force? We have no idea, but it's going to be really exciting to find out.